Hey everybody, welcome to the video, and today we're going to be going over the new updates and character balances to the game. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to go over in the patch notes are the general fixes. So here we are. Melee targeting improvements. Melee attacks without lock-on are now easier to hit. Target prioritization is improved, especially for sprinting attacks and Tooke's heavy attack. Melee attacks on crouch enemies should now hit more consistently. Tree branches and leaves collision on outposts fixed as so they don't block arrows and bolts. A new option called assassination camera allows players to disable to take down mini cutscenes. Temporary community events and rewards are now displayed in the game. Alright, those are all the general fixes that are in this new update. So let me know what you guys think about the general fixes. But onto the character balances that you guys have been waiting for. First nerf goes to Marianne. Aiming now requires stamina and halts stamina regeneration. Roving rogue reworked. Previously with the perk, Marianne would pick up two bolts from a single bolt in the environment, with her bolts having a 25% chance to break on impact. Now with the perk, Marianne picks up one bolt from a single bolt in the environment, but with her bolts no longer break on impact. Increase the delay between the moment Marianne aims and is able to fire, effectively removing quick shots. Smoke bomb now affects AI in a smaller radius. Alright, not bad. On to the next legend. John. Surging Smash no longer kills Tooke in a single hit. Surging Smash no longer removes stamina for performing light attacks while sprinting. John is now able to use Wrath to cancel assassination attempts on his life. John is now unable to be assassinated when under the effects of Wrath. He still remains vulnerable to the Sheriff. John's sprint attack is now less generous in terms of hit detection. Tooke's heavy attack no longer collides with friendly characters. Healing gas no longer affects AI negatively. Poison gas now affects AI in a smaller radius. Poison gas no longer hides the player from the Sheriff. Other guards are still affected. Robin. Amy now requires stamina and halts stamina regeneration. The flashbangs inflicted stamina penalty increased. The flashbang is now more effective, removing UI elements such as the minimap or characters that are affected. The flashbang removes lock-on and prevents affected character from locking on for the effect's duration. Smoke bomb changes. Here's the effects for a person inside a smoke bomb's effect. They are unable to see the UI overheads for clients outside the smoke, health, and tag icons. They are no longer tagged by clients outside or enemies outside or guards outside the smoke. They are no longer displayed on an enemy's minimap or map. A person outside of smoke bomb's effect is unable to see overheads for clients that are inside of smoke, health or tag wise. They are also unable to tag and see tags for enemies inside the smoke, is unable to see enemies inside of smoke on the minimap and the map. Locking on targets that are inside the smoke bomb's effect now requires the enemy to be much closer to be able to do so. When two or more enemies are inside the smoke and sufficiently close from each other, they will be able to see each other's UI overheads, health bar, and tag icons as well. Alright, the final things to go over in the new update is the bug fixes. So, they fix a rare PC crash after the Alt and Tab button while in full screen mode. I have no idea. But I'm not a PC player. Fix a rare PS4 crash when launching a heist on a coastal map. Fix a rare PS4 crash when trying to find a match in training mode. Fix a rare PS4 crash when joining a squad 20 plus times. Fix other rare crashes. Various localization fixes. Various UI fixes. Fix network error on a PS4 and PS5. Fixes bug where muting another player from the map could cause one player to stop their movement while the map is open. Fix a bug where players get stuck on the map UI after muting another player. Fix an invitation bug where players remain in their hub after being invited. And the last one is fix flash bombs resetting Robin and Marianne arrow and bolt charge. Alright. So those are all everything in the new update in the patch notes that I've read to you guys. And what do you guys think about the character buffs and nerfs to all the legends? And tell me what you guys think, and did the devs do enough to keep you guys playing? Or are you guys going to wait for the new game mode? Let me know down in the comments below. And again, I'm dan.v, and I appreciate all my outlaws and anyone new to the channel and to the game here. So I'll see you guys in the next one. Everyone stay safe.